How are you doing that, Clouds and York? And welcome to Whatever Happened to Ruth MacArthur, which I believe this is a horror game. I'm not sure about that, it was more of an investigative type horror game. And about someone called Ruth MacArthur. C-I-S-S-S, in the Apagon, anyway. So let's get into this thing, because I don't know, there is tick options. That's fine, I guess. Play! Yep, that's where I got these. See these things? These are headphones. They're saying, my hair, boom, the roof, it's loading. Also, this didn't download like in a normal way for it. It gets down like it was a separate PC game, so maybe it's that good. Oh, elevator. This is a nice elevator. This is a nice house. Nice roof. Piano. So it's at door number one. Or not. Okay, can't chuck it. Oh, okay, we're going there then. Can't take all the doors in, I guess. That's a nice painting. There's a few girls fucking some goat man. What's this? Okay, what's the newspaper say? The Birmingham Post. Babyface is sought after station block. Okay, what? Hello? Hello? Anyone there? Hello? Then. With a nice hat. Also your paintings, all I seem to be dynamic. This is a really fancy house you got here, Ruth. Loads of radios. And the piano playing in the background. Let's see what's in the bedroom. I'm supposed to put this on somehow. Look at the Hey.
Don't you cry. Go to sleep.
Okay. I don't know what's happening there. Hey. Have you seen directed around there? Am I missing something? Well, probably over here. Just saying.
Take one, September 1st, 1973. Yeah. I was sent a strange gift from a fan of the show, I presume. My interest in the unloved esoteric texts have not escaped this mysterious benefactor.
Okay, in Birmingham, England.
It's a shriveled little grimoire bound in sickly smelling black leather.
It's the Necromonicon!
It's
no!
It's written in a completely idiosyncratic Cyrillic. The book seems to act as a series of instructions and invocations to go.
Barado Nictar. Barado Nictar in the other two words.
The illustrations feature some kind of a spirit with the head of a horse.
Okay.
It looks like a couple people are trying to translate it. It'd be simple enough to pick up where they left off.
Bad idea, Wolfie. Bad idea. Dearest Mary, I wish I had more time, but I'm afraid that's an emotion that will fear me from you. I'm sorry I was so cruel. I wish I could take all that pain from you and bring it with me into the dark. There's so much I wish I could tell you, but maybe you would understand. Despite all that happened, all that I've done, I love you, Ruth. Oh, well then. Anything else? The door closed behind me, so... Anything else here? Oh, there's the number one. To the number one! That was hard to find, that was really random, you know.
Tape 2, September 8th, 1973. Further studies of the Grimoire have revealed a curious magnetism.
Magnetism, eh?
As I translate this obscure language, the words just sort of slip off the page and find their way into my head.
That's a very book.
I found myself repeating certain phrases under my breath, like some queer melody without tune. From what I've pieced together so far, this book claims to contain a ritual that can send you into the red womb, or stomach.
Okay, what?
I haven't translated enough to know it. Can't seem to shake this morbid curiosity. There's something ancient about this book.
The grimoire, what do you think?
Like a vestigial fear of a predator that has long been extinct.
Any more? Any more? There's one. These appearing out of nowhere. They're appearing out of nowhere, aren't they? They're fishy.
Take 3. September 10th,
1973. My book there! You know, I wasn't born there.
This book is starting to invade my dreams.
That's a weird book.
I'm half awake in bed.
I'm half awake, but it is fear!
Heaviness.
Yeah, it's a demon book, don't touch it.
I feel the wind
it's a bad
on my face.
Mojo, no!
Pulsing kind of breeze that smells of honey. Something else.
Honey?
I open my eyes and I'm still in the apartment, but it's mostly empty. The walls are red.
They're red.
There's an awful wind bashing on the windows. It's unbearable droning. The television is on, I can hear something through the static. Some awful sound, like a chorus of horses in the line of a glue factory.
Okay.
The book is open.
It'll never be closed.
Words shift and dance on the page like candle flames.
You shouldn't have
touched
it, did you?
I can't read the words, but in some strange way, I know what they mean.
Okay.
I've invited something in.
You're an idiot, Ruth. That's what you were missing for. Hello? Hello there, what's going on here then? You got a license to turn it on. Oh shit. Well that's new. I can't read these words. Okay. I was running just here to get the other one, weren't I? They say we'll read hellos at the bottom.
No! You must not read from the book!
Back to the TV then. Back to the TV. That's loud too. Anyway, take two.
Take four, September 12th, 1973.
Are you going a little bit more
the
crazy?
The steady wind that has set upon my home. I'm lamenting, cold. Having some strange fever with it. I can't let it distract me from the task at hand.
Get the book anyway.
I must be the one to bring this book out of the obscurity. To know it. To understand it.
Understand it.
I had a sleep last night.
You're a skeleton, mate, aren't you?
You know, they got back into the game and you fear the worst at that point, but I think we've showed today that we're going to go to the wire, we're going to go all the way. You know, nothing's won yet, but that was probably the biggest statement we've made so far.
The book says that you mustn't linger in there. And I understand now. To linger is to be broken down, digested and reformed, and expelled into some unknown place.
Go back in there then. Let's look around for the other tapes. Yeah, looks like we had to go in there. You mustn't linger though, you know, like it owned. Oh shit, okay. Back out. Go back out, boy!
Tape 5. September 13th, 1973. I haven't left my apartment in some time. Something tells me that I'm staying here.
A little bit quick, way.
Being away from the book, it makes me feel sick. Hollow. When I'm away from the brook, I feel minus something. Like a vase in want of flowers.
Yeah,
I'm beginning to get these visions of a far-off place. A place where great pines pierce the sky like black spires. A thick blanket of slate clouds weighs on the valleys like the lid of a well. A sharp cold penetrates the skin where the black mud has clung. There's a marble wall in face of a cliff. A mighty cave that burrows unknowably deep into the mountain. And a howling wind that pulls you limply forward. The air smells sour.
Where do we go now? Go back in there again or? I'm pretty sure that's the last take away the sound by the end of that, so. There's another one. Back out, boy! Back out again! Well, there's another one after this, to be honest.
Tape 6, September 14, 1973. I couldn't resist the pull of sleep. In a moment of weakness, I shut my eyes and found myself in the red place. This realm throbs and pulses. It's a kind of static
in the air.
The smell of blood and honey, stronger than before.
Smell of blood and honey and the
there's a buzzing
blood and honey.
Voices on the radio. Using a sequence of words I can hear. I can't remember. Against all logic, I feel as though I've begun some process. I don't have the knowledge to stop. The boat rings and I pick it up. I can't remember who spoke. I began to weep, began to cry out, a primal sob that I couldn't control.
Throw the book away then.
David? Mary?
Who? Mary?
Whoever finds his tape. For the love of God, burn that book.
What book? Phone ring now, as I said about the phone ringing. That's the radio. There's no phone in there, is there? Heard the dead bone! I need that bone! No phone in there, let's go and get that book ring, because I don't know where that actually is. Where's the book? Oh, stuck on the thing. Okay, this is the last one.
Tape 7, September
15th, 1973. Got a little bit quake, aren't you?
I didn't dream of the red room tonight. I dreamt I was lying on the floor of a stable. My mouth tasted of blood and honey. I could hardly breathe.
Very random, blood and honey, isn't it?
I could hear a little girl sobbing. My neck was long.
What were you?
Stretched out. My face extending to the bloodied muzzle. My lungs were caving in. My eyes milky. A man stood over me.
Go on, a bit quick, quick.
My countenance of pity and concern. A knowing look. Of knowing what must be done. Of unborn regret. There's a rifle in his shaking hands. My mind is animal. Scrubbed clean.
Oh, so you turn into a demon now, yeah?
I've been here before.
Oh, Will no one be around here? Oh, I have no clue. Back into the room, probably. I'm not sure. This is a really investigative game, just saying. Back into the TV, boy! In an empty, really empty room. Ruth, my love, through my heart I can't hear what this letter I must have thought was right for the both of us. We cannot go on like this. You become a stranger to me. I tried to reach out. Despite all that we've been through, you refuse me. Maybe one day I can forgive you. Maybe. You think I'm cool. Just know I always loved you. But so have Mary. Last one. Let's go, boy. Back to the TV. That's what loud me, isn't it? Last one. Tape 8.
September 16th.
Sounding weird.
1973. All the history of the modern age accords with his metal throat.
All the metal throat. All the instruments of the metal age accords with the metal throat.
Adores. He lives in the cathodes. The glorious rays. The poison light. His kingdom is as thin as his feet, yet infinite in its bound. His voice is in the ferrochrome, and our words mingle there like ink in water.
Yeah, listen carefully. We know what happened to her now.
And you can hear him swimming in the static.
Alrighty then. Is that it or? My little bear. Going that one a bit off. Am I Mary or am I again? Didn't say who I was. You go back in here again. Here it is.
Tape 9, September 17th, 1973.
So I get all day to do in here.
You are in a dream. It's most pertinent to know who the dreamer is. The walls are red, but I'm not sleeping now. The white mare runs at night, carried by the northern wind.
Yeah, they're staying in longer,
soon
boy.
I'll my amniotic home. The grimoire is complete. All is quiet now. The green door has been unlocked.
Yes, he's probably got taken somewhere.
White ware has arrived.
Green door.
I must wait in that gate. Beyond the north wind. There is no pain.
Alright then.
There is no sound. There is no light.
The green door. Taken somewhere. She went a bit cuckoo and got taken, and obviously I'm doing that same place. Going to the light, baby. I don't know where I'm going, but going somewhere. Going somewhere. Going somewhere. Going somewhere. Going somewhere, probably. I'm going into the light. Going into the sweet light. Let's get going and going. Going, baby, going, 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 baby. This is the end of the game, so it's a good investigative game, not gonna lie, it's never done. Whatever happened to Ruth MacArthur and whoever I was playing too, just saying. Impressive investigation game that is. That was what happened to Ruth MacArthur, and that was an investigation game. I think it could be considered horror, probably, because she was like meeting a grim one and some horse thing speaking to her. She's going a little bit nuts and blood and honey. I wonder what blood and honey would taste like, just saying. Anyway, just so yeah. So, that was quite an impressive investigation game. So yeah, so, if you enjoyed this and want more, don't forget to click on Mother Darkness and smash the like button, boys. Stay spooky. Toodles!